It's a real shame. The lad had lots of potential. Just a shame he was a moron. Some people have brains, some people don't. Sean didn't.
In 2010, at the age of 16, Sean Sutton was signed by Manchester United Football Club. For precisely 3 months, he was the highest paid 16-year-old in football. He now works for the Fishmongers and plays for a Sunday league side. Where did it all go wrong? We're here in Salford, Sean's hometown, to find out.
Well, let's get things straight. First of all, it had nothing to do with a lack of talent. When I was on the pitch, I was graceful. I was like a ballerina. I was something else. I was uncomparable to anyone else. If the tabloids didn't say what they did say about me and make all them lies up, I'd still be in the starting 11 for United today. It is what it is, though, really, isn't it?
Due to the lack of evidence against Sean, we were unable to take legal action. However, based on the in-game footage and the rumours going around the press, it's pretty clear that he was match-fixing.
I mean, if you're going to cheat at something, at least do it well. There was one point where the lad was getting the ball and he was just passing it away. I mean, that's madness. How's he thinking he's going to get away with that?
The match-fixing allegations were bullshit. That's all I'm going to say. Let's just carry on.
But could you just tell me a bit more about them?
No.
Sean Sutton, yeah, he's a dickhead. Never really liked the lad, he's a bit of a dickhead. I've only been in the league one season, but just can't stand him. One minute he's rolling around on the floor in agony, next he's up doing dirty tackles. He broke one of my mate's legs a couple of weeks back. He's absolutely delusional. He played for Man U, what is it, 5 years ago now or something. He's still got a bloody agent. I don't know what he does. The pair of them are just as bad as each other. They're disgraced. You know, we're trying to get Sunday League back on the map, and it's an absolute joke that we have to have players like him. It ruins it for the rest of the lads, really. Don't like him at all.
What do I think he's doing now? Well, I doubt he's got a good job, you know. He might be in a factory or something. He could have been one of the stars, you know, your Gerrards, your Rooneys. But, well, he wasted it, and I can't see the lad having a good job.
At the moment, I'm just working down the market as a fishmonger with my mate, Barra. Like, it's all right, like, don't pay as much as Man United did for professional football, but as its perks, do you know what I mean? Like, get a free fish every Friday, and I get to be a little bit closer to wildlife, so happy days.
Some people say to me, Sean doesn't need an agent anymore. Do you know what I say to them? Sean is just as good now as the day I scouted him. Let's be honest. He's got the pace, he's got the power, he's got a good head to him, knows where he is in the box, keeper's not got a chance.
Oh, Simeon's great. I can't say enough about him, to be honest with you. The guy supported me through and through, through all the lies. He's always been there for me. He was there through the bad times, been there through the good times, and I hope it's a friend I'll carry through to the end. I owe him a lot, and I've got a lot of love to give for my agent.
I supported Sean on and off the pitch. I was his biggest supporter. I was there every game with his supplies, just what he needs to keep him ticking over.
Oh yeah, of course, mate. I'm always out partying. There's nothing else to do, really, if I'm not fishmongering, if I'm not out there Sunday league, top of the goal scoring list, I'm out there having a bit of a biggie with the women, do you know what I mean? I'm quite popular out in the club life. People, I know people, do you know what I mean? I know them contacts, so I don't have no trouble when it comes to partying, really. Come out with me one time if you want. I know.
Sean did like a party. Partied hard. I was there most of the time. Bit of this, bit of that, bit of scrapping. You know, average night.
Well, I never personally met Sean, but I saw a couple of interviews he did, and he wasn't the brightest spark, I'll say that much. I mean, He was just a 16-year-old kid they took out of school to come play football and it showed.
You see, the thing is, when the tabloids were saying what they were doing, it was a really hard time for me. So I felt like I had to look for some kind of escape, you know, something to return my zen kind of. So I turned to poetry, and it's something I really got into. I felt like I had a lot to talk about, my career, the city I live in, my mate Badder. So I made a little rap. Would you like to hear about it? Okay. Just give me a... 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Yo, yo, I was a footballer. It was the tall order. My manager used to say you need to try harder. So I thought about it. I knew I weren't at the sharpest. I took a dive and everybody started to talk about it. Why can't it be forgotten? The shit you said was rotten. In the end of the day, it was only against the team called Tottenham. What do you think? All right, yeah. Next Eminem? Maybe? No?
He's selfish, don't pass. It's like, if pass ball to him, he goes on and scores, just doesn't...
So this is my abode. Mi casa. Oh, I don't know the rest, just make yourself at home.
Whenever I play FIFA, I like to play as myself. It just reminds me of the good old days, really. Scoring goals, just playing a full 90 minutes, really. Something I never actually got playing at United. So it's a good way of just reconnecting with my past. I enjoy it. I think everyone should be play themselves on FIFA, really. Luckily for me, I don't need to create a player. I remember Platini once said about Maradona, Diego was capable of things no one else could match. The things I could do with a football, Diego could probably do with an orange. And I'm pretty sure that applies to me too. Apart from the second bit though, I don't really like oranges, to be honest.